Given that American democracy in peril may not be the New Year's message you're hoping for, here's a silver lining. The United States may not have its house in order, but neither does China. And that reality, I am confident, is one thing that will prevent any cold or, God forbid, hot war between the two great nations in 2022. Don't get me wrong, the two countries have no trust and will continue to confront one another over all sorts of issues like technology and trade and COVID, not to mention the future of Taiwan. In fact, when I asked retired four-star Admiral James Stavridis last May where he thought a U.S.-China war would be most likely to break out, he didn't hesitate.
Taiwan. I think it would be a miscalculation on the part of the Chinese, but they may calculate that now is the moment.
But here's why I don't see war anytime soon. China is aware of the economic stakes involved, and it's got far too much on its plate to afford the risk. The economic growth engines China has relied on for the last 40 years to lift hundreds of millions out of poverty are running out of gas. Job losses in wealthy countries that have brought so many Chinese-made products have forced a reshoring of manufacturing away from China. Advances in automation and robotics also cutting into China's lower wage advantage. China also faces a demographic cliff. Its population will begin shrinking in 2027. That's before China becomes the world's largest economy. The labor force contracted by 40 million workers over the past decade, and the share of Chinese citizens over 65, now at 13.5%, is going to nearly double by 2030. That's going to drag on growth and force the Chinese government to spend a lot more on healthcare. Added to that, the world's most indebted country, China, is now facing a crisis in its property and banking sectors as Beijing's move to crack down on debt pushed real estate giant Evergrande to the brink of economic collapse and over $46 billion in losses back in 2021. I'm not sure how you say too big to fail in Mandarin, but in China, I bet they do. So while Chinese leader Xi Jinping will continue to stand up for Beijing's interests at home and abroad, China's historically ambitious and risky reform plans are going to increasingly demand the leadership's full and undivided attention. Nationalistic chest thumping over Taiwan, we can both do that. But there's no crisis point soon.